On the third day after he had offered up this prayer while he was sitting on the banks of the river that flows forth out of paradise, there appeared to him in the heat of the day the angel Raziel, bearing a book in his hand. The angel addressed Adam thus, O Adam, why art thou so faint-hearted? Why art thou distressed and anxious? Thy words were heard at the moment when thou didst utter thy supplication and entreaties, and I have received the charge to teach thee pure words and deep understanding, to make thee wise through the contents of the sacred book in my hand, to know what will happen to thee until the day of thy death. And all thy descendants and all the later generations, if they will but read this book in purity, with a devout heart and a humble mind, and obey its precepts, will become like unto thee. They too will foreknow what things shall happen, and in what month, and on what day, or in what night, all will be manifest to them. They will know and understand whether a calamity will come, a famine or wild beasts, floods or drought, whether there will be abundant grain or dearth, whether the wicked will rule the world, whether locusts will devastate the land, whether the fruits will drop from the trees unripe, whether boils will afflict men, whether wars will prevail or diseases or plagues among men and cattle, whether good is resolved upon in heaven or evil, whether blood will flow and the death rattle of the slain be heard in the city. And now, Adam, come and give heed unto what I shall tell thee regarding the manner of this book and its holiness. Raziel the angel then read from the book, and when Adam heard the words of the holy volume as they issued from the mouth of the angel, he fell down affrighted, but the angel encouraged him. Arise, Adam, be of good courage, be not afraid. Take the book from me and keep it, for thou wilt draw knowledge from it thyself, and become wise, and thou wilt also teach its contents to all those who shall be found worthy of knowing what it contains. In the moment when Adam took the book, a flame of fire shot up from near the river, and the angel rose heavenward with it. Then Adam knew that he who had spoken to him was an angel of God, and it was from the Holy King himself that the book had come, and he used it in holiness and purity. It is the book out of which all things worth knowing can be learnt, and all mysteries, and it teaches also how to call upon the angels and make them appear before men, and answer all their questions. But not all alike can use the book, only he who is wise and God-fearing, and resorts to it in holiness. Such an one is secure against all wicked counsels, his life is serene, and when death takes him from this world, he finds repose in a place where there are neither demons nor evil spirits, and out of the hands of the wicked he is quickly rescued.